Hi guys, welcome back. Today we will see about the benchmark cheating. So if you haven't heard about this thing, so OnePlus device named as OnePlus 3T right here has been caught cheating with the benchmarking scores. It's not a new first time this thing happened, and we will see why these things needed, what happened, what is the benchmark cheating, how you can do that, how you can avoid that. So let's go back a few years back on 2013. So this is the first time when the manufacturers were being caught. So there is a company called Primate Labs which create benchmarking applications called the Geekbench. So that time it was, I guess, benchmark 2 or 3. The first time this accident happened when the Samsung device was caught cheating with the benchmark score. So they were playing with the GPU score, and this thing has been caught by the XT developers. I'll put the original link, so take your time, it'll take 10-15 minutes, go and read complete things. So anyway, at the end, all the manufacturers stopped doing this. But after a couple of years, say 4 years, so there's a new test has been done. So this is here, OnePlus 3T and the Google Pixel XL, so both running Snapdragon 821. Now the Snapdragon 821 has a unique property, like when you open any application, it actually increases the clock speed. So most of the devices have some set of, you know, clock speed limitation, which is measured in the gigahertz. So I'm taking an example of the OnePlus 3T here, because this is the device in the picture. So it has a clock speed of 1.6 gigahertz for the lower cores. Actually this device has a 4 cores, it's a quad core. Alright, and the highest one has a 2.35, so 2 cores are of 2.35, 2 are 1.6. So whenever you launch any application, say it is a smaller application, Facebook, so it being used by the smaller cores, because if you use smaller core, it's not going to use much power compared to the bigger ones, right? But when you need heavy graphics intensive, say games or benchmarking, then it uses the higher cores. So how these things have been caught? So the XT developers team were playing around the Snapdragon 821 phones. So they launched similar set of applications in all the phones and opened it and just left it idle and keep on doing other stuff. So they found that OnePlus 3T was maintaining a little bit higher clock speed even though the application was idle compared to other phones, since both are running the same processor. So something fishy was found. So ideally, when you open some different applications, clock speed were at 0.7 GHz even at 0% CPU load. But when you run some applications like benchmarking or gamings, like I don't know the games, but some games were there, so it maintains a speed of 0.98 even though it is 0% threshold. But the other devices running 821 processor, they haven't such kind of issues. So that means something has been added to this OnePlus 3T devices, that it actually increases the clock speed, then you will get the better game benchmark and other scores like Antutu. Now how did the XT developers find it? So they went back to the Primate Labs, they contacted it, and they created a new code, actually new application to the same code that was used in the Geekbench Mark 4. So they named as a mini code, and they just changed the application and everything else, and instead of, you know, app name, say Antutu Geekbench Mark, they are using the package name. Package name, actually you can say when you submit any app to the Play Store, it should be as a com.android or google.something xyz. So that's called package name. So they trying to identify this thing. So in that case, when the CD was not able to detect like which kind of application it has to be hard coded, and anyway it got failed to detect, and it shows a regular clock speed and some lower benchmarking scores, not that lower but just a 5% max of difference. So that's how they been caught. So this is about the story. So what we learned from this, if you're trying to buy any phone and if you have no brand specific name and you're just looking for the specs and comparing the devices, the benchmarking, so don't get a believe in this, because benchmarking changes this time, and I never believe that. If you are my follower and subscriber, you might have seen in each videos I did shown you previous steps, like, you know, the score was that much, now it has been changed. If you're running again, you'll get different result. And yeah guys, one more video you should watch, and I have one test between OnePlus 3T and the Google Pixel XL. I was trying to run an Xbox stream, so that was the time when the game was launched new and the phone was launched too. So I suspect that OnePlus 3T has hard-coded Xbox stream, because if I'm trying to launch that game, it takes just a max 1 or 2 seconds to launch the complete game. Even the Pixel was taking 5 to 6 seconds. So you can watch that video, you will get to know. It was so freaking fast, this OnePlus 3T. So it looks like it has been hard coded. So that may be the reason why suddenly, you know, apps launches so fast with just 2 gigabytes RAM difference. So anyways, this is the story. So make sure to watch that video and read the complete article of the XT developers, you can get to know better. So use the device personally. If you're going to buy any device, watch your favorite reviewers video after monthly usage review, like how much things happen, how it works. Don't just believe on the number. And this thing came only with the community build. When it was on the marshmallow, there was nothing there. when the computer came, actually the hydrogen OS and the oxygen OS being merged together. So that's how this feature came here. And I guess they just know this, but intentionally they done it. Anyways, it's a bad thing. But they finally acknowledged when the XT developers contacted them, and they said that they will remove this benchmarking limitation from the apps of the oxygen OS code. Alright, and this thing is also present in Android Nougat builds for the 4.2.2. So check out my previous videos. I've shown you a lot of speed test comparison and the beta build comparison of the 3T3 platform. So there you have it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. This is Saurabh. I'll catch you next video. Have a great day.